7 Bangor.
This is ABC 7 News at Noon.
Hey Susan, happy Thursday afternoon. Your first weather forecast brought to you by Luigi and Fredericks, across from Eastern Maine Medical Center, serving the greater Bangor area for over 65 years. Already a small crowd advisory is in effect, lasting until 8 p.m. on Friday because we have a system moving in, bringing rain and, of course, some gusty winds I'll have to watch out for as well, which will help to stir the ocean up. But for now, we are watching the clouds moving in from the west to the east. Rain across the northern parts of the state. It'll take a little bit for it to try to sneak into our backyard. We'll have to wait until tonight and maybe into tomorrow before the rain starts to fall in a few spots. Zooming things out, this is the leading edge, though. A warm front is moving in, so some warmer air will be moving in soon as well. And plenty of rain chances for us, especially as we head towards Friday night and a Saturday. For now, though, temperatures aren't too bad. These were the overnight lows this morning, the middle to upper 40s, even lower 40s further off toward the north. So a little bit more mild, but overall, not too bad overall. But again, the winds will start to get a little gusty soon, as well as the clouds moving in, too. We might notice a little bit of cloud cover from time to time, though, at least a few breaks of it, but the rain moving in, especially later on in the day into the overnight period as well. Now the wind's showing some gusty winds up to around 10 to 15 miles per hour in a few spots. Higher gusts close to 20, maybe 30 miles per hour are not out of the question. So that hourly forecast for the rest of the afternoon period. Plenty of clouds, maybe a few sprinkles further off toward the north. Temperatures that will make it into the lower to middle 60s early on. Your full five-day forecast is coming up. Susan?
Thank you, Devin. The Thomas Bonfanti trial began with the defense taking an unexpected approach during the opening statements. A.J. Douglas has the details.
Day one of the Thomas Bonfanti trial included testimony from eight witnesses, including Regina Hall, who survived after Bonfanti allegedly shot her in the face. During opening statements, Bonfanti decided to address the jury in place of his defense lawyer, Jeffrey Toothaker.
I have done a lot of trials, and I have never had a client do his own opening, so that was unique. I'm curious as to how it impacted the jury.
The Maine Attorney General's office took a more traditional approach by discussing different elements of the case. Friends and family members broke down in tears as they recounted finding the lifeless bodies of their loved ones.
Now, today's was a lot of pretty damning evidence. He doesn't deny it, he does it. He did this. He just wants to explain what happened.
Trial is expected to advance within the next few weeks. We are following the trial closely and will keep you updated along the way. At the Waddo County Superior Courthouse, A.J. Douglas, ABC 7, Fox 22.
A Holton man has been indicted on child sex charges. The Penobscot County Grand Jury indicted 55-year-old Morris Carr on 8 counts of gross sexual assault. Carr was arrested in March for gross sexual assault of a victim under the age of 12. Police say there are multiple alleged victims in this case. And 49-year-old Christopher Hussey was indicted in connection with a series of fires in the Bangor area. Police say that fires happened at several businesses between November of last year and February of this year. Hussey was indicted on 6 counts of arson and 7 counts of failure to control or report a dangerous fire. A Dixmont woman is facing drug charges. During a traffic stop on May 23rd, a Penobscot County Sheriff's deputy stopped a vehicle on Moosehead Trail Road in Plymouth and detected suspicious behavior and items associated with drug trafficking. During the investigation, authorities identified a female occupant as 36-year-old Kendra Mason of Dixmont. She was out on bail for drug charges. They say after searching the vehicle, the deputy found methamphetamine and fentanyl. Mason was arrested for trafficking in Schedule W drugs and violation of conditions of release. She's currently at the Penobscot County Jail. A reward is being offered for information about firearms stolen from a Waterville business. Just before 3 a.m. on April 10th, two masked people broke a window and entered JR's Trading and Pawn. Police say they smashed the glass display case with a hammer and took 14 handguns. The ATF and the National Shooting Sports Foundation is offering a combined reward of up to $5,000 for information leading to the arrest and prosecution of the people responsible. Anyone with information is asked to call the Waterville Police Department. Across Maine, schools are on edge after the shooting in Texas. Mel Meyer reports.
It's alarming.
Parents across Maine are hugging their kids a little tighter today.
It's happened so much in our country at this point in time. I don't know how it doesn't resonate with people.
It can happen in Maine, and it will happen in Maine. I just hope and pray it's not us.
RSU-16 in Poland just had its own scare last week. A middle school student allegedly had a kill list with the name of staff and students on their laptop. The district immediately jumped into action.
What was that like to have this happen to the district?
It's frightening. We have to investigate it to the nth degree to make sure that there's no merit to it.
While schools have implemented safety measures, the superintendents we talked to say they can only go so far.
We need to have these conversations about how we maintain maximum amount of security within our buildings, but you can never add enough layers of that.
Instead, people need to be vigilant and report any issues. In the meantime, the Maine Education Association is trying to help school staff navigate another national tragedy.
Their students will be coming to them with questions or wanting to talk about this and trying to find the right appropriate ways to handle that.
The union that represents more than 23,000 educators is offering resources on how to have those conversations.
Know that our educators do everything they can to support our students and to reassure them and to keep them safe. That is absolutely topmost in everyone's minds.
In Washington, there is more talk about gun control as bipartisan talks are underway. ABC's Aika Jachi has the latest.
In Uvalde, a familiar argument over gun safety erupting at this news conference. Beto O'Rourke, a Democrat running for governor, interrupted the current governor, Greg Abbott, calling his response to the shooting totally predictable.
He says this was unpredictable. It was totally predictable, and I predict this will continue to happen when you continue to have a governor who will not stand up for the people of Texas.
But in Washington, the familiar arguments are leading to new discussions, at least for now. Senator Susan Collins, a moderate Republican, has already met with other senators to discuss Maine's so-called yellow flag law, which is similar to red flag laws in other states, allowing authorities to temporarily take guns away from people determined to be dangerous.
I certainly hope that the Senate will take action. This was a horrific crime.
And Republican Senator Mitt Romney is now signaling he's open to revisiting a bill proposed by Democrat Joe Manchin and Republican Pat Toomey, which would expand background checks, including for sales online and at gun shows. Senators Manchin and Toomey introduced the bill after the Sandy Hook school shooting in 2012. The 60 Senate votes needed to pass any new gun legislation still seems highly unlikely, with most Republican senators avoiding questions on the issue yesterday.
Do you support expanded background checks? The majority of Americans support it. Do you support it? The majority of Americans support background checks. Do you support it?
Polls show 56% of Americans support an assault weapons ban, 86% support a red flag law, and 89% support background checks. Texas Governor Greg Abbott once supported a red flag bill in Texas, but backed down from the idea after pressure from Republicans. Since then, Texas has repeatedly loosened its gun laws.
Coming up on ABC 7 News at noon, Senator Susan Collins took to the Senate floor yesterday and blocked a key Commerce Department confirmation. We'll have the details when we return. We'll be right back.
I got hurt bad in a car accident and I need help, but I don't have money to hire a lawyer.
It doesn't cost you anything up front to hire us. We only get paid when we win your case. So you can keep your money in your pocket.
I called the twos and it was free to hire Lowry and Associates. My money stayed in my pocket and they got me $300,000.
I'm Jim with Lowry and Associates. Call the twos. We win for you.
If you're hurt in an accident, what do you do? Call 222-2222.
The secret of every great chef is their knives and how well they sharpen them. Imagine a knife taking this much abuse and didn't need sharpening. Imagine no more. Introducing the incredible NutriBlade knives from Granite Stone. Coated with Granite Stone nonstick and made of stainless steel. One of the hardest substances on earth for ultimate cutting-edge durability. Now everyone can chop, slice, and dice just like a pro.
Very comfortable. Wow. Very sharp.
I thought you had to be a professional chef to cut like this.
Yeah. Woo! This is really an incredible knife.
The Easy Grip rubberized handles deliver incredible control and accuracy to chop salads in seconds, cut frozen solid meat with ease, and get razor-thin slices every time. The non-stick surface means food slides right off, and they're dishwasher safe. Plus, they'll stay razor sharp, guaranteed. Why pay hundreds? Today, you'll get this complete set of six NutriBlades for only $29.95. You'll get the powerful Santoku knife to chop large fruit and dice onions, the slicer for razor-thin veggies and deli meat, the serrated bread knife for slicing fresh, warm bread with ease, the ultralight chef knife with reduced surface area for less friction. This versatile utility blade is great in the kitchen and around your home. And the precision paring knife for peeling and garnishing. $29.95 is an amazing value, but order right now and we'll even ship them to you for free. So get your own NutriBlade knives from Granite Stone, the last knives you'll ever buy.
To order, call 1-800-530-7638 or go online to buynutriblade.com. That's 1-800-530-7638 or go to buynutriblade.com. Order now.
You're watching ABC7 Bangor.
Senator Susan Collins took to the Senate floor yesterday and blocked a key confirmation of a top NOAA official for the Commerce Department in an effort to trigger progress on new rules Maine lobstermen are facing. Collins rejected the unanimous consent request to confirm Jane Kuma Bavishi to be Assistant Secretary of Commerce for Oceans and Atmosphere. The move comes in response to the National Ocean and Atmospheric Administration's, quote, stonewalling and refusal to modify its new rules, which are intended to protect North Atlantic right whales. Collins' office says her action is intended to pressure NOAA to be more responsive to Maine lobster industry as Maine lobstermen and women struggle against supply chain shortages while converting their gear to meet new requirements.
We have had countless meetings with the Department of Commerce, with NOAA. I met with the Fisheries Administrator in NOAA. I asked for his help. He promised to work with us. Instead, things have gotten only worse.
Collins' office says she hopes the move will persuade NOAA to pay closer attention to the agency's own data, which shows the Maine fishery has never been linked to a right whale death. The owner of Zolke's Tree Service in Orono has been named this year's Maine Young Entrepreneur of the Year. Maine Small Business Administration is handing out awards this week to some of the state's best small businesses. The list of award recipients includes 27-year-old James Zolke, the owner of Zolke's Tree Service. The company specializes in residential and municipal tree cutting services in Orono, Old Town, and the greater Bangor area.
Definitely flattered. It just speaks, to the quality of work that we do and, the caliber of employees that we have, that we're able to put out consistent, good work for folks.
Zolke and the rest of the Maine SBA winners were recognized at an awards ceremony Wednesday night in Hollowell. With Thursday's business news, here's Leo Jonasson.
Stock markets around the world mixed overnight after the Federal Reserve confirmed more interest rate hikes due this year. Board members indicated they support half-point hikes at their next two meetings. Apple is going to boost pay for workers across the board. The Wall Street Journal says the company will set starting pay for hourly workers at a minimum of $22 an hour, a 45% increase from 2018. Dick's Sporting Goods has cut its earnings outlook for the year after first quarter sales dropped nearly 7.5%. Revenues came in at $2.7 billion, beating expectations. And Oreo and Ritz have announced a combination mixing the classic Oreo cream filling with peanut butter. 1,000 packages are available through a giveaway on Oreo's website. I'm Leo Jonasson with Thursday's Business on ABC7.
Here's a special traffic note. The Maine Department of Transportation is working on completing paving work on I-95 between exits 174 and 187 in Bangor. The project involves the closure of interstate ramps from 8 p.m. until 6 a.m. It is scheduled to be finished by July 14th. This is the final part of a project that began in August of 2020. The department has opened all the East Dabsguk Stream Bridge, which is the first of four bridges that will open up this year. The Center and West Dabsguk Stream Bridges are expected to open next month. The last of the four new southbound bridges is scheduled to be opened in late August or early September. Additionally, there will be overnight closure of the Emerson Mill Road in Hamden between 7 p.m. and 5 a.m. starting Tuesday, May 31st, running until Saturday, June 4th. Coming up, the Maine CDC has identified a case of acute hepatitis A in an Oakland food service worker. That's next. We'll be right back.
Hey everyone, Emeril Lagasse here, and I'm so excited to tell you about my French Door Air Fryer 360. This is my biggest air fryer yet. Extra large 26 quart capacity. Cook with up to 70% less calories from fat than deep frying. That's a big deal, my friend. It's all about the air crisp technology. 360 degrees of superheated air gives you fast, even cooking. With 24 preset cooking functions, doesn't get any easier, folks. My 10-in-1 French Door Air Fryer 360s grills, air fries, dehydrates, roasts, bakes, broils, proofs, slow cooks, and toasts. I mean, this baby does it all.
These French Doors are a game changer. I mean, look at how easy that is. One-handed.
It's super stylish and super easy to use. Every kitchen needs one of these.
Cook for your entire family in one compact kitchen appliance. Now find out how you can try Emeril Lagasse's 26-quart French Door Air Fryer 360 with three cooking tiers, fetch tool, air frying rack, and drip tray in your home for 30 days for just $14.99. Order now and you'll also get Emeril's Air Fryer Favorites recipe book. And we'll automatically upgrade you to our bonus cooking kit free. You get bonus number one, the baking pan to broil and bake family-sized meals. Bonus number two, the crisper basket for golden, delicious air-fried food without oil. Bonus number three, the rotisserie spit set for the most delicious chicken you've ever tasted. Bonus number four, our grill plate to sizzle succulent steaks and a 100% satisfaction guarantee. Plus, find out how you can get free shipping. This offer will not last, so call or click now to order.
You're gonna love it, I guarantee it.
To order and take advantage of this TV-only offer, call 1-800-738-2613. That's 1-800-738-2613, or go to EmeraldFrenchDoor360.com. Call today.
I've been having foot pain for at least 10 years. The first day I put the key boot on, I could tell the difference. My pain level has been so much better, I was amazed. The key boots made it possible for me to actually walk without pain. I can go shopping, walking around the store without wanting to cry. I mean, I feel like dancing sometimes. The key boots made all the difference. Very happy with it. Comfort shoes, it's just changed my life.
The Maine CDC has identified a case of acute hepatitis A in an Oakland food service worker. The worker handled food while infectious at the Waterville Country Club's 1916 restaurant in Oakland between April 26 and May 17. Anyone who ate food from the restaurant during this time period could be at risk for hepatitis A infection. The CDC recommends getting a hepatitis A vaccine within 14 days of exposure. A stray starburst under the cabinet, a lost M&M in the couch, we've all had them, but to a toddler, finding old candy is a surprise. Families can run into trouble when their young children mistake missing medications for sweets. With more, here's ABC's M. Nguyen.
Every year, 40 to 50,000 young children go to the emergency room because they got into a medication left within reach. Many drugs can be extremely toxic or even deadly to toddlers given their small size. The CDC has a few ways to keep your children safe. First, store medications on high surfaces, out of reach and out of sight. Get down at your children's height to see the room from their level and see what's accessible from their perspective. Next, talk to your child about the dangers of medication. Be clear that many pills that look like candy are not candy at all. And lastly, keep medication in their original child-resistant containers. The locking mechanisms are designed to prevent young hands and curious minds away and safe. With this Medical Minute, I'm M. Nguyen, ABC News.
When we return, Devin Biggs has your five-day forecast.
They're here.
Okay. There's no way we're paying for all those medical bills.
Should we talk about a settlement?
How about we cut the car payments down?
We might want to think about this.
Look, just get them to sign. This offer's more than fair.
Sir, it's the law offices of Joe Bornstein.
Call Joe. The law offices of Joe Bornstein. Right now.
You can handle this one.
JC Auto Body is expanding once again. Welcome to JC Auto Express, our new 5,000 square foot state-of-the-art facility, offering our customers the same great experience, now in as little as 1 to 3 days. Because who cares about your time?
At JC Auto Express, we do.
Exact color match technology, certified aluminum repair, plus JC Auto Express will even take care of your rental car. Because who cares about you?
At JC Auto Body, we do.
Your favorite restaurants for half off. It's half off dining from Fox 22 and ABC 7. Go to foxbangor.com, click on half off dining, and start saving now.
If you need coffee,
check.
Tasty treats,
check.
Freshly made pizza,
check.
Or wine and spirits,
check.
Stop by and fill up your tank and check us out.
Great restaurants from all over Eastern Maine at half off dining from Fox 22 and ABC 7.
He said there was no leak from my apartment.
A neighbor's downstairs downpour.
You will clearly see the valve leaking.
So you were in his apartment?
That's correct.
At first you told me that's not true.
Will his defense go down the drain?
The leak was as a result of your apartment.
Mr. Schlegg is president of our homeowners association, so there's a clear conflict of interest.
This case is a farce. He did this himself.
Next Judge Judy.
Thursday at 5, only on ABC 7.
When Devin Robinson of Carmel came home, a new house appeared while she was at school. Emma Smith has the details.
Over the past few months, the community of Herman and Carmel have gathered around Jordan and Devin Robinson in response to the recent passing of both their mother and father. The sisters were left to pick up the pieces in January of this year, but they haven't been alone. Since then, the community has stepped up to help and donate by any means necessary. And yesterday, they were able to finally check out their new home.
I was expecting to turn into the house and see the slab of concrete like we had, and then the whole house is here.
I just kind of woke up and it was here, and I wasn't fully awake yet, so it didn't fully register at first.
Herman Town Council member Steve Thomas organized a GoFundMe page that managed to meet its $40,000 mark. But with the home and many other services being additionally donated. All of this has been in order to keep the girls on their family property, but now with a sorely needed new roof over their heads.
Many people came forward through the GoFundMe site. People donated there. We had contractors that wanted to get involved.
Liz Jonathan, known to the girls as Aunt Liz, said, "It's just unbelievable."
But their mom, for years, has voiced to me that she wanted to give the girls a new home.
The new home is the culmination of efforts from more than who can be listed here. And though it does still need a few final touches that Thomas is looking to find donors for. Front steps and a back porch are needed, as well as pickup and disposal of the previous home. Those seeking to help with these needs can contact Steve Thomas at 735-8977, which can be found on our website at foxbangor.com. In Bangor for ABC 7 and Fox 22, I'm Emma Smith.
Memorial Day weekend is almost here. Acadia National Park officials are expecting big crowds. Sierra Jordan explains.
Memorial Day weekend is considered Acadia National Park's busiest time of the year. The deputy superintendent of Acadia is advising folks to park your patience and prepare for the upcoming traffic.
It's really weather dependent how many people could come this weekend, but we expect a lot of visitors.
According to National Park Service, Acadia welcomed more than 4 million people in 2021.
We ask people to plan ahead for your visit, plan where you're going to go, and have a backup plan. A lot of our parking lots might be busy or even full, so they may need to go to a different location.
Bai says Jordan Pond House, Sand Beach, and Ocean Drive are the most popular attraction spots at Acadia. He says there are several alternative spots just in case the parking lots are unavailable.
There are some places in the park, like along Ocean Drive, where there's a second lane and you can park on the side. But there's other places, and we usually have them pretty well marked, where we really ask you not to park on the shoulders.
Bai says visitors over the age of 15 are required to have a park entrance pass. Vehicle registrations are also needed for Cadillac Summit Road. If you plan on using the bus shuttle, the Island Explorer doesn't begin service until June 23rd.
You can purchase ahead of time, or you can purchase at one of our entrance stations, at Sand Beach Entrance Station or at the entrance to Cadillac Mountain.
Bai strongly advises folks to dress accordingly. If you plan on hiking the trails, he says masks are required to enter park buildings to prevent the transmission of COVID-19.
The most likely ways to get injured when you're here is to be not prepared and not wearing the right footwear. Also, you want to make sure you bring plenty of water and otherwise just have a great time out on the trails.
In Bar Harbor, I'm Sierra Jordan reporting for ABC 7 and Fox 22.
Now your full forecast with Devin Biggs. The holiday weekend's coming, Devin.
All righty, thank you very much. Your full weather forecast brought to you by Scott's Recreation, New England's largest trailer dealer, home of Maine's lowest camper and tractor prices, with locations in Turner, Manchester, Herman, and Orono, Maine. Already a small crowd advisory is in effect until 8 p.m. on Friday. Gusty winds will be picking up with an area of low pressure that will be approaching, which may cause some issues with some of the smaller boats out towards sea, though. But meanwhile, the clouds are moving in. A little bit of rain possibly across the northern ends of the state, so we'll be watching for this throughout the daytime. Say it'll sort of sink into our backyard later on tonight and tomorrow. Better chances Friday night and a Saturday as the system right about in here starts to track off towards the north and east. So this will push high pressure away. The rain will move in. A few soggy days will soon be on the way. Wave heights starting to increase a little bit, around 3 to 4 feet, according to some of the buoys. So this is why those alerts are now in effect. And the winds are starting to increase as well. Gusty winds getting up to around 25, maybe even close to 30 miles per hour in a few spots. So we'll keep that going through the overnight period and even into tomorrow as the system continues to move through. Our average high is 69 degrees. We're going to be short of that by just a few degrees in the middle 60s. Then warming up into the middle 70s by Friday, lower 70s Saturday, upper 70s to lower 80s Sunday into Monday. That will feel nice, right? The middle 70s on the way Tuesday into Wednesday. And again, it's going to be feeling a little bit muggy as well as the temperatures start to rise. Your muggy meter showing a little bit of a rise in dew point levels as we head towards Friday into Saturday. In the lower to middle 60s and even in the next week as well. So with the temperatures starting to rise a little bit, it'll start to feel a little bit more muggy. So future cast for today, that the clouds will be the big thing we're watching out for. The rain will stay in the northern parts of the state. We'll have our turn for a little bit more rain shower action as we head towards the evening period later on tonight and the parts of tomorrow as well. We have to wait till about Friday night into Saturday before our better chances for rain begin to move in. And even a few rumbles of thunder with this multi-day system that will continue to move in, though. So once we get past Saturday and a Saturday night, this will finally begin to get out of here, take the winds with it. And by Sunday, things will begin to look a lot better. So with how much rain we could possibly see, the heaviest of the amounts will be in the northern ends of the state, where about 1 to 2, maybe even 3 inches further off for the north are not out of the question. Other areas could see up to a half inch or less possible, maybe a little bit more further off toward the north and lesser to the south before all this begins to taper off. So a forecast for today, 66 degrees under a mostly cloudy sky, a south wind sustaining at around 5 to 15 miles per hour. Later on tonight, 53 degrees, rain shower, some patchy fog as well. A south wind getting up to about 10 to 15 miles per hour. Looking ahead towards tomorrow, 76 degrees, some morning fog, then rain showers as well. South wind at about 10 to 15 miles per hour. All right, your Scott's Recreation extended forecast. Storm chances on the way as we head towards Saturday, highs in the lower 70s. We rise into the upper 70s on Sunday under a partly cloudy sky, and a slight chance of rain on Memorial Day, highs in the lower 80s.
Thank you, Devin. That's all for ABC 7 News at Noon. Thanks for watching. I'm Susan Farley. We'll see you this evening with Peter Dubois and Beth Jones on ABC 7 News at 6. Have a great weekend.
Really? Raise a glass to a brand new week of Wheel.
You started a book club. It's called Books and Booze.
I did. We meet at a local brewery and talk about a book.
They don't actually read the book, but you put your beer on the book and you don't make a ring on the table.
Plus, this week, one of these players makes a bonus round solve.
None of the consonants was up there. You'll need more than that.
That leaves Pat completely stunned.
Don't make the host look stupid.
Weekdays at 7 on ABC7.
You're watching